Peace, family. This is Sage Love, founder of Anika Production, Inc. I'm also a writer, director, producer. And today, we're going to be talking about opening your mind and, you know, just overall skill sets and things you need to do to make it in life, right? It's important to open your mind. It's important to have an open mind when you're an artist, especially when you're starting from the ground up. You know, your foundation has to be solid. You know, that means waking up every day, making it your intention to do better, to be better. You know, looking inwards within yourself. You know what I'm saying? And when you do that, you then bring out something that people can relate to, you know, because we're all one, we're all interconnected, you know. So I can only speak for myself. When I make something, I'm always looking for the feel. How does my work make somebody feel? You know, the intention that I'm trying to bring out to people. And first, I have to look within myself first. When I'm writing a story, envision it in my mind, right? And when I envision it in my mind, I put myself in my character's shoes, and then I write it down, you know. And since I'm open-minded, you know, I see the signs that the universe is giving me back, you know what I'm saying? Because we have the universe inside of us. We have God inside of us. Prayer is when you talk to God. Meditation is when God speaks to you. Right? Now, what is meditation? It's simple. We meditate all the time. You know what I'm saying? When we daydream, we meditate. When we listen to music, that's a form of meditation. You know what I'm saying? There's different forms of meditation. It's just when you enter that zone that nobody else can. You know what I'm saying? And that's where I want to take this. You know, when you're an open-minded individual, that means you're not fixed on one lane. You know what I'm saying? You are open to many lanes. And there's so many lanes. You know, God will send you so many things that will make your dreams come true. That will make your whatever you want to do come true. Sometimes failure brings you down. But I've looked at failure in a different sense. To fail really means first attempt is learning. First attempt is learning. Which means you gotta keep trying. You can't stop the first time. You know what I'm saying? You gotta keep trying. You gotta keep going at it. You know, when you was a baby, right, and you was first learning how to walk, right, did you stop the first time when you fell? I don't think so. Because if you did, you would not be walking today. What did you do? Kept going at it. You fell, you got back up. You fell, you got back up. You fell again. You fell a million times and you got back up a million times until you learned how to walk. And it's not the end. You know, I have another acronym for the end. End really means effort never dies. You know, your effort is what's going to really push that drive to making it happen. Your effort. You have to put in the effort. You have to. Right? And then rejection is a no, right? Next opportunity. Another acronym. Go on to the next one. That's what I mean by open-minded. You can't just, you know, think that the first time is going to work. You're going to be rejected all the time. And there's always going to be new opportunities. That's why you got to keep going. You have to keep going. You know what I'm saying? No really means next opportunity. You know what I'm saying? That's rejection. We all get rejected. So just breathe. You gotta keep going. Right? And you know, it's just positive thinking. It's positive thinking. You know, and then you gotta hold yourself accountable. You know what I'm saying? If you really want it that bad, you gotta hold yourself accountable. You gotta stop procrastinating. You gotta wake up early in the morning. You have to, you know, chase that. You gotta chase that dream. You have to chase that dream. Because nobody else is gonna do it for you. Nobody else is gonna do it for you. You know? And I constantly remind myself that I am both a masterpiece and a work in progress. We are all both masterpieces and work in progress. You know what I'm saying? Expand your skills. Expand, you know what I'm saying? If your lane, me, I'm a filmmaker, right? And I know my lane is writing, directing, and producing, right? But I couldn't find an editor. You know what I'm saying? I couldn't find a cameraman. You know, I couldn't, you know, find somebody to take pictures for me. So what did I do? Was I going to wait and, you know, look around for those? I could have did that, but that's not who I am. You know what I'm saying? So what I did was I took it upon myself to learn those skills, to learn how to use the camera, to learn photography, to learn how to edit my own films. You know what I'm saying? And it made me more valuable because I'm not just a writer, director, producer. You know what I'm saying? I can literally wear all the hats that's needed for me to make a film. You know what I'm saying? Right now, I don't have to do that. In some occasions, you know, I have to. But, you know, I learned that skill set because it was important. And because I didn't want to depend on anybody. You know what I'm saying? You got to do it yourself. You know? And I'm not saying reject help. You know, I'm always welcoming help. But if down the line, you know, if I don't find anybody, I can do it myself. You know what I'm saying? I've trained myself to do that. You make your opportunity. So what I want you guys to do right now is make your opportunity. If the door closes, make an opportunity. Next opportunity. That's a note, right? You know what I'm saying? So it's just, gotta keep going. Gotta keep going. So I hope, you know, you like this video. You know, again, I'm Sage Love. And I hope everybody's having a blessed day. And I hope you guys walk away learning something. Peace.